This is the story behind two ColecoVision games. Breakout, in year 1999. Dacman, in year 2000. Back in the 80s, Canadian Tire did a games compilation for the Commodore VIC-20 computer. I didn't realize the impact of this tape in my future projects. Remark the names: Games Pack, Dacman, Rocket Command, Breakout, and Tank vs. UFO. Let's start with VIC-20, Breakout. This is the game Breakout I played when I was a young boy. I never played the arcade version. This game has nice colors, nice sounds and rebound effects. Please remark the ball movements, only in four directions. And now, my own ColecoVision version of Breakout. It's the first Coleco game I programmed in my life, and I did it in a single day. You select first the number of balls, then the game starts. The bad thing about this version is no information printed on screen during the game. See the ball movements, like in the VIC-20 version, in only four directions. You can see the ball destroys tons of bricks in a second. I will let you watch this footage for a moment. The next level is the same, but the gameplay is faster. You can find the public domain ROM file in my website. A cartridge named Deflector Collection can be played only with the steering wheel, the roller controller, or a custom paddle. Let's continue with the VIC-20, Dacman. I'm not talking here about this game who looks like Pac-Man for the Atari 2600, it's another Pac-Man, also called VIC-Pac-Man, but simply named Dacman, in the games pack. This is the first Pac-Man version I played in my life. Everything is made with characters' graphics. The maze looks blocky, the gameplay is slow, and the ghosts are not chasing you. Notice the movement speed is the same for you and the ghosts, making the gameplay different than the arcade game Pac-Man. Imagine now the same gameplay but faster, with better sounds and graphics. Well, it's what you get by playing my own Coleco version named Dacman. Yes, it's called Dacman because of my name and because of the game I played long time ago on my Commodore VIC-20 computer. If you wait the information screen, you can do one of these two special codes with your Coleco controller. One code gives you more lives, and the other one allow you to play a secret bonus game. The gameplay is the same. The ghosts are not chasing you, but you can hold diagonal direction to easily run through multiple paths. There is music, cool sounds and graphics, fruits to collect, and rewards after finishing at least the last level. Talking about levels, the first ones may look familiar to some arcade gamers. You can see here why using the same speed for everybody makes the gameplay challenging with sometimes extremist saves. The speed increase at level 4. The speed and the maze change at level 6. I said earlier to remark the names, Games Pack, Rocket Command, and Tank vs. UFO, not because these names refer to Breakout or Dac-Man, but because I did a Coleco Games Pack which included Secret Games, Rocket Command, and Tank vs. UFO. The speed increased even more at level 9. Holding diagonal directions may help you to win the game, especially at this speed. A new maze at level 10, with warps in 4 different directions. A bronze medal reward. The game starts all over again from the first level. And then at level 5. A silver medal reward. And then at level 10. A gold medal reward. You finally reached the secret last level, a very tough and fun one. And now, the ending. July 2000, Dac-Man was released during the Classic Gaming Expo in Las Vegas, thanks John Dantzilla. Thank you for watching the story behind my Coleco Games Breakout and Dac-Man.